A Story from Camelia's Album. The Case of the Reckless Hedgehogs by Carlotta Mastrangelo. Read by Louise Gold. A Story from Camelia's Album. The Case of the Reckless Hedgehogs. Chapter 1. Camelia and Her Friends. Camelia, that's me. I'm 7 years old and I live in the city with my parents. I go to school and I like animals. Actually, I love animals. I have an album that is a big scrapbook where I've stuck all the most beautiful pictures that I've found of animals and the places where they live. By looking at the creatures carefully and watching what they do, I've found out that every single one of them is really special, whether they're big or small, plants or animals. And this album is really special too, because when something bad happens to the animals or plants, my album knows and it tells me. And then we set off on a mission straight away. Every time our help is called for, we go to the place where it's needed. My friends and I, of course. Let me tell you who my friends are. Ping and Gwyn, the twin penguins. Well, by profession, they're actually slippers. Ping is the blue one. He's sweet and timid. Gwyn is the crafty one. Sometimes she's a bit of a show-off, and she's always getting into trouble. Oh, Tico. He's a red panda with a beautiful tail. Tico loves joking around and playing in a team. This is Wolfie. He looks like a draft stopper, right? But in reality, he's a very special sausage dog, and with his amazing sense of smell, he'd be a perfect detective. Sometimes he speaks with a stutter, but we don't care, because what he says is always right. Anya, she's my goose friend. She was born as a rucksack, but she's very, very clever. When in danger, she's perfectly capable of defending herself, and she can give deadly pecks with her beak. Oh, Totter. Totter is a cactus, so it's normal for her to have a spiky character, or spiky, as she says, because she speaks with a lisp. Totter is the only plant allowed in my house. And everyone knows she's a good cactus beneath her spiky skin. Chapter 2. Time for Bed. It's late in the evening and all is quiet in Camelia's bedroom. The window shutters are rolled down. The draft stopper, a funny long sausage dog, is stretched out on the floor by the window. Camelia's clothes are neatly folded on the chair ready for the next day, and her school bag, a rucksack in the shape of a goose, is hanging on the arm of the chair. Her penguin slippers are also lying tidily at the foot of the bed. But in the darkness, whispering can be heard, coming precisely from those two slippers.
No!
Yes!
See the squeaky voices of Ping and Gwyn, the twin penguins, who continue their bickering.
No! Listen, I was first.
Shh! Camelia hushes them from under her bed covers.
Be quiet, you two. Mum will be here any minute to say good night.
At that moment, their whispering is interrupted as a blade of light cuts into the room and the shadow of Camelia's mum appears at the door. Mum quietly enters the room and softly steps to the bed to tuck in Camelia. Good night, my treasure, Mum whispers as she gently strokes Camelia's prettily plaited hair.
But Camelia already seems to be breathing peacefully, and Mum is convinced her little girl is fast asleep. Satisfied, Mum creeps away and closes the door behind her.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.